Have you been thinking about where you're going to find your next superstar? Businesses are really struggling right now to find those, the next leaders, those next up and comers. It's a hard market out there. So if you've been struggling to find that next leader, superstar for your business, we're going to help you solve that issue here today. My name is Corey Harlock. I'm the creator of Key Hire. Welcome to the Key Hire Solutions podcast for small business. Whether you're listening to us on Spotify or Apple or Amazon, watching us on YouTube, on LinkedIn, thank you for joining us today. Our guest is Paul Pasoli, and Paul is the creator, founder, engine behind CareerSpring, and we're going to learn all about what CareerSpring is in a minute. But I just want to take care of some housekeeping. If you are a small business owner and you're looking to optimize your business through talent, that is something Key Hire can definitely help you out with. So feel free to reach out and check us out. I think the second podcast, Matt, with the new music, I like it. Love it. Tapping the desk, getting ready to go. Our old music was a little sleepy. But I think that's about it. Am I missing anything, Matt? Do we need to talk about anything? I'm not seeing any comments, so I will assume that's no. So without further ado, let's bring on Paul Pasoli. Paul, how you doing?
Corey, great. Thanks for having me.
Am I saying your last name correctly?
You did. When you were about to say it, I'm like, oh, here we go. Let's see if you can get this right.
Awesome. So we met, and I've never given my wife a shout out on the show, and I think we've done about 20 podcasts, and I don't think I've ever given her a shout out. But
that's so good.
She connected you and I because you connected with her.
Right.
How did you connect with Claudine?
Yeah. So, well, we're going to talk about the mission of CareerSpring, but one of the things we do is we set up advisory boards in every city that we launch.
Right.
And Claudine became one of the advisory board members for Houston.
I was a horrible decision to put her on there.
Yeah. And Sterling Group, put a shout out for them. Sterling Group is one of our employer partners. So that's
yeah, they do. Too. They do good, honest work over there. They're a good, for they're sure. a good outfit.
For sure.
So are you the founder of CareerSpring? Was I correct? Am.
Yeah, we launched in August of 2020. I'm the founder and president.
So give us the goods. What is CareerSpring?
I've got a dog sitting here too. I don't know if you've ever had this happen on a podcast, but I got a dog that's giving me a hard time right now. So awesome. Anyway, he's behind me now.
That's all right.
We're a nonprofit. We're an online networking and job placement platform for first generation college students. These are students whose parents didn't go to college, didn't get a college degree, and or low income students. So that's what we're doing. We basically have three primary areas of support. Number one, we have a career video library, and this is where we're literally gathering videos from professionals that just talk about what they do every day. So, hey, what's a day in the life of being an engineer? Well, electrical engineer, mechanical, civil, petroleum, right? There's all different types of jobs.
Sure.
It's like an online career fair, incredibly scalable. Today we have 450 videos. I think we've had 15,000 views, but we'll have, if we don't have 100,000 views within 5 years, I'll be disappointed. So incredibly still.
We got to get you there faster than that. Okay.
Yeah, let's do it. Yeah.
We can give you some exposure.
Thank you. Yeah. So that's number one. Number two, we have an advisor forum. And this is where students can have one-on-one video consultation. We call them consultations, but basically conversations. And I know you've had you're an advisor and you've had a conversation.
Yeah. And it was, I got to tell you, the young gentleman I spoke with, he was out in Washington, had the story, and it was, he came super prepared. I was really impressed with him. Open, honest. It was just a really cool conversation. And I think the reason I became an advisor with CareerSpring and I wanted to have you on and I like the platform so much is, you know, I resonate with the story. You know, it's, I could be one of the young professionals on the website looking for a job because that's my story as well. And it's most of our story, right? Most of us don't get to be in the top 10%.
That's exactly right. And we love having advisors who had similar backgrounds, right? That's fantastic because they can resonate. It resonates with the students. And today we have 1,100 or so, about 1,100 professional advisors on the platform. You know, we launched in August 2020, so we're only 2.5 years in, but so far, so good. And I think the bet we're making is that many people want to give back, but they probably don't have the time to be a mentor, like officially every Saturday for 3 hours.
Right.
And I think that most people have the ability to have a call once a month with a young person that's trying to break into whatever their profession is. So
right.
We think we're onto something there, and that's the advisor form. That's number two. And then the third thing are job placement services. And we're basically asking employers to consider posting internships and entry-level jobs on our platform. And we will help them find candidates, and we'll screen the candidates for them and prepare them for the interviews. And then ultimately present great, gritty, determined candidates for the employers.
And you use the word that was the genesis of my next question, because these kids, we'll call them young adults, young professionals, that's what they are, right? They have grit, they've overcome, they've found a way to create a path that is different than what has historically been in their family. And they might not be coming out of, you know, the Ivy League institutions, but I've always been a fan of, if someone's story is, I paid my own way through college,
yes.
I worked while I was in college because I, you know, my family couldn't afford to put me through there, I will bet on that person 10 times out of 10.
Yeah, well, of course, I agree with you. And
yeah.
And adversity, right? A lot of these students had to work through high school and college. It was maybe they're helping take care of their siblings. Yeah. Lots of challenges and adversity. And as you know, we grow with that, right?
And
gets thrown right out the window. So you've got this entire generation of talent that's coming up that want to work hard, have worked hard, aren't entitled, and being able to reach them, right? That's the secret sauce for small businesses.
But what you just described is the anti definition of the up and coming workforce that people are, some owners, business owners might be frustrated with because they're not willing to do the work. So this might be like this really cool and interesting and effective pool of people that these people are really looking for, but never knew how to reach them. Just like these young professionals don't know how to reach these business owners. And so CareerSpring puts this neat little hub in between to allow these people to connect.
That's exactly right. Yeah. I mean, I just from background standpoint, I spent most of my career in the energy business, but I had the opportunity to go and lead a high school for low-income students in 2014. I went over there to be interim headmaster, essentially, got there, fell in love with the students and the mission and the families. And I ended up spending 5 years. So I basically, after 20 years in the energy business, ran a high school for 5 years. And what I found is that a lot of the students were doing everything right. They'd go to college, they'd work hard. Many of them were making it to and through, meaning getting to graduation. But when they graduated, they just didn't know anyone. They literally would go 99 yards, to use a football analogy. They get to the one. We're all cheering for them because they graduate and they don't have any social capital. They don't have information. They don't know anyone. And so they go on to be underemployed. They'll apply to jobs on some online platform, not hear anything.
And hope take a job. Like climb the ladder or whatever, right?
Exactly. And employers, I mean, I was at a bigger company, but coming from JP Morgan, I knew that, you know, we were struggling to find talent. So you've got this amazing dynamic here where students don't know about opportunities. Employers don't know about these students. 30% of all college students happen to be first gen. Just think about that for a second.
That's
right.
We're
talking about millions of students whose parents didn't go to college and they don't even know about all the different opportunities. At the same time, 80% of all jobs are filled by personal professional connections. So just think about that dynamic. I don't know anyone. 80% of all jobs are filled by personal professional connections. And we've got this gap. And so, yeah, CareerSpring was formed really to help match. Really just, look, there's all these amazing, gritty kids. And there's employers that need talent. let's put the two groups together with an emphasis on that social capital thing, having the conversation with you. Because what I found is anytime I made an introduction, it almost always resulted in something positive. So I was really intrigued by that leverage. Like, man, it took me 20 minutes to introduce this young person to Corey, and now that they're fully employed, that's a great use of my time. How can I do that at scale? Career Sprint.
Everyone wins.
Right.
And so the you know, you talked about that social capital and things, and you know, because I kind of came up similarly, I've come I became aware of a term called the dinner table conversations, right? And so if you're working or your family circle or circle of influence isn't aware of what's beyond where they are, those dinner table conversations aren't, hey, when you graduate from school, I have a connection, I want you to meet someone, where are you going to intern? Have you thought about consulting? Have you thought about the big five? Have you thought about banking? Those didn't exist in my world, right? It was like, hey, this, what do you want to be when you grow up? I want to be this. Good luck, right?
Yeah, and yeah. In my case, it's very similar. In my case, I said, well, what is the one major that will get me a job? And they're like, well, accounting would get you a job. You probably get a job. And I'm like, sign me up for accounting. I need a job. That's it. It's not what am I interested in, you know, I had a very similar situation.
Yeah. And so in my experience with my mentoring experience was, you know, it felt like it was a dinner table conversation. Someone who maybe has a view to, above the bar, right? Above the bar that person is currently, the ceiling that they're wedged under, just because of their circumstance, right? And so I might have a view above that, so I can kind of crack that open for them and give them some things to think about or point them in a direction or give them a resource that will then hopefully it'll just like explode and they'll go, oh, wow, like pull it on a thread, right? And it just kind of, they get all this new information and these new contexts and they see new interactions and they hear different language and all this stuff.
It's invaluable. It's hard to quantify, right? I know the impact is exponential, right? Because if this young person then gets on a path to full employment and their siblings and cousins see that and their children, right? What is the impact of potentially one or two conversations like that? It's extraordinary, hard to quantify. I've got some incredible anecdotal wins, but I'll tell you a quick story. I had a guy from JP Morgan called me and said, Paul, you're not going to believe this. He said, we just interviewed this young man. And he said, all he could talk about was Career Spring. And I said, well, did we introduce you to him? He said, no. He just came through the JP Morgan process. And I said, okay. And he would tell me what he said. And he said, well, he told us that he was interviewing for a private wealth job at JP Morgan. And he said, he's had 15 consultations with private wealth people from different companies. And he said to the interviewer, there's nothing you can ask me that I won't know the answer to because of these 15 people that have told me everything I need to know about private wealth. And by the way, 18 months ago, he didn't even know what private wealth was. And I said, okay. And he said, yeah, we gave him an offer. I'm like, all right. Well, so
cool. That's it. So cool. Okay. So you said you're a not-for-profit. I want to touch on this. How do you get your funding? How can people contribute? If they don't have time to donate to it, can they donate dollars to your cause? How do we keep this machine running?
Thank you. Yeah, well, our website is www.careerspring.org.
Matt.
And there is a donate button if people are moved by what we're doing. Of course, we appreciate the support. The primary business model is that we ask employers to consider becoming a partner. And if they'd like to make a sponsorship and become a sponsoring partner. So we have about 110 or 120 companies now that are partners. Most of them are sponsoring partners.
Awesome.
And you don't have to make a donation. So we'd love for employers to come on as just partners, even if they don't want to make a donation to Career Spring.
Paul, do they pay for the placement, like if they hire someone?
No.
Okay, so I don't work for Career Spring. I'm not a paid employee, so I can say this. Look, if you want to sign up and get these great kids for free, donate to the cause, help these guys out, help keep this going so you can keep growing. How many cities are you in now?
So because we're an online platform, interestingly enough, right, it's been cool to see the organic growth. I think now we have students from over 200 cities that are on the platform, 550 different college universities. However, as I mentioned earlier with the advisory boards, we've officially launched in 9 cities.
So
and
cool.
Meaning in those cities, and it's Atlanta, let's see if I can do it. Atlanta, Boston, Dallas, Chicago, Houston, the Bay Area. Did I say Detroit, LA, no. New York? No. I don't know. But that's basically big cities across America. We're going to be in every city in the U.S. It's just a matter of time.
Love
and,
it.
And we form these advisory boards, and then we just start opening doors. We probably haven't said this, but CareerSpring is a free resource for any nonprofit, any college or university that serves low-income students, first-gen and low-income students. So that's where the students come from.
Right.
We have over 125 organizations that we partner with that we give them CareerSpring for free. Those organizations funnel their students into the CareerSpring platform. And today we have over 12,000 users on the platform. We expect to be over 20,000 by the end of the year.
Awesome.
So we're still early stages, but as your listeners think about what's possible as we grow across the country, you know, we intend to be the number one networking and job placement platform for this population of students. So we think we can help a lot of employers.
Love it. And so when you deal with a college, you're not just kind of advertising to those students. You're going to the career centers and things within the college and saying, hey, let your student body know we are a resource for them beyond you as well. We can kind of dovetail in with what you're doing or be an added resource to their job search. Is that kind of how that
Correct.
Works?
Yeah, we kind of look at ourselves like another arrow in the quiver for a career services department. We're not going to replace them. They do what they do. And we'd love for them to share this with their first gen and their low-income students. So think about like the Pell Grant recipients on campus. This was CareerSpring was set up for them.
Okay. Awesome. So we always like to transition into some mistakes. And the first mistake a small business owner would make with CareerSpring is, and it's not their fault, they might not be aware of it, right? So now that if they're listening to this and they're like, hey, this sounds like something I should check out, you know, what are kind of some of the common misconceptions or hurdles or mistakes an employer might make going into CareerSpring and trying to engage with or hire someone from the platform?
Yeah, I mean, I guess I'll start by just saying, I think the first mistake, that's the wrong word. It's not really a mistake, but the reality is that things are changing in our country, right? Demographics are changing. Baby boomers are retiring. So I think employers aren't necessarily aware of the fact that, like I'll use Houston as an example, under the age of 21, only 20% of the students in Houston are white. Just think about in 1980, 80% of the population was white. CareerSpring is not necessarily a diverse platform. We're about socioeconomic backgrounds. However, just so happens 95% of our students happen to be diverse because of the nature of urban America. But that to me is very interesting. If I'm an employer, man, so the way we hired 10 years ago isn't going to work as well today. And 10 years from now, will probably not work at all. So that's an important thing to understand who we're trying to reach. Okay, and if we don't know how to do that, well, we need to find some ways to reach that next generation of talent. Of course, at CareerSpring, we think we could be helpful with that. And as we talked about earlier, the other thing to note for employers is these students wouldn't know about your company, most likely wouldn't know about your company. They just haven't been made aware. They don't.
And they're small,
they haven't tried.
These are small businesses, right? Like, you know, $25 million. They're not in the headlines. They're kind of just the little companies that are driving the economic engine of the quietly and discreetly driving the economic engine of the country.
That's exactly right. And that's what excites me so much about the small business owner as it relates to CareerSpring. The small business owner has a lot of flexibility. They can make a decision, right? They don't have this certain rubric. If the student didn't go to Harvard, I'm not hiring them, right? So what an amazing opportunity, right? That most of the jobs in America are probably funneling. I don't know the number, Corey, you probably do, but are funneling through this group of small businesses. And it just seems like an awesome opportunity to hire this group of talent. So anyway, then you asked, what mistake do they make when they onboard? I think, and I'll say,
what can they do better, or, you know, what might they miss? It doesn't have to be the mistake, but kind of what should they know?
Yeah, I think they should know that these students maybe aren't as prepared for the interview in the first place. I mean, we do, I think, at CareerSpring a really nice job. People like you are generous with your time to get them prepared for the discussions. We have candidate coaches and we do a lot of good things. And they haven't had those conversations at the dinner table for the last 10 years with dad. And so they'll come to the interview and they may not even be aware of some of the things that you would expect them to be aware of. That doesn't mean that they won't be CEO in 20 years. It means that they're just not as prepared for that piece of the puzzle. And then when they come on board, maybe they've never had an internship before. So comparing them to the kid that's been interning with you for the last 4 years is a little unfair.
Or the kid that's been working at their parents' buddy's business during the summers when they've been maybe working just to make money to pay the bills at a food service job or a quick service restaurant. Now they're in a professional engineering environment or something like that, or manufacturing environment. And this is new to them. They've gone to school for it, but they haven't actually done anything inside those four walls.
Well said. Exactly. Yeah. So being aware of that, I think it's an awareness thing. And making sure the employees are all aware of that, right? That we're all, the objective here is to onboard this, well, find this next generation talent and train and retain them, right? We want this to work so that 5 and 10 years from now, these people will have bigger roles inside the organization. And so the first 6 months are probably the most challenging.
That aligns a lot with what I talk about with business owners. When you hire on potential, which is what these people are, right? We're not hiring them for their expertise. We're hiring them on their potential. And there's a couple of things that come with when you hire people on potential. You can expect to pay them a little less, right? Because they don't have the experience, but the ROI is a long tail ROI. If you're expecting to hire someone on potential, pay them less and get immediate results, you're setting yourself up to be disappointed. They will never, very seldom will they meet that expectation, right?
I agree with all that.
Yeah, so if you're hiring on experience, this person's got 10 years experience, you're gonna pay more for that and the ROI will come faster. They should be able to walk in and know a lot about that job, and you should be able to see that payback happen faster. Those are kind of the extremes of that spectrum. And so what I think I'm hearing you say is we're hiring strictly on potential here. So the ROI is going to take a while. We're going to need to train. If you're going to bring someone in, have an idea at minimum of what training might look like, or have a really good person you can have them follow around for a couple weeks so they can figure out where the bathroom is and kind of the general workflows and get asked those uncomfortable questions that they might, as a business owner, they might not want to ask you because they might be embarrassed or not comfortable asking you that. But give them that buddy that they can build a relationship with and feel comfortable asking questions and kind of, because I think once they get comfortable and understand what's going on, they're going to take off, but you got to get them to the point where they're comfortable, especially if, I don't know if I'm overstepping my bounds, but you know, you might not have a culturally diverse workforce and then we're bringing diversity in, you know, the whole D&I thing. And so there's a little bit of that too, right? So we got to kind of all work together and pull on the rope together to make sure we're everyone is set up for success.
Yeah. I like so much of what you just said, and rather than looking for experience on the resume, looking for attributes, right? Like interviewing for attributes. If I ask most owners of businesses, what's the number one attribute you're looking for? I bet you a large portion of those people would say hard worker.
That's exactly what right? I was going to say. Yeah.
Right. And so let's interview to find out if this person's a hard worker. Let's really dig. Tell me about the experience when you waited tables at that restaurant. Did you have to stay late? That kind of thing.
Paul, I don't think you need to dig that deep. If you say, so you went to this university and they say, yeah, I paid my own way through. How'd you do that? I worked full time and went to school full time.
Hired.
You're a hard worker. That's kind of a no-brainer, right?
Exactly right. Yeah, it's funny because I speak with a lot of students, and often they're on the resume, they're like, well, I didn't put that I'm working 30 hours a week at this. I'm like, no. You need to put that. Like, that is your number one attribute, right? Yeah. They think it's because it isn't it's not related to whatever they're trying to interview for, that it's not that important. But back to attributes, let's get that hard worker every time.
Even taking that in the step further, they might even think it would hurt their chances by putting it on there, right? But that's the thing these kids need to understand, is you're not selling your experience, you're selling your potential. And so we need to make sure we're building the resumes around, look what I'm willing to do and have done to get where I am. And why would I stop doing that when I come and work for you?
Exactly. Thank you.
Awesome. Yeah. I'm a small business owner and I want to see what Career Spring's all about. I want to take action and look at the talent pool and see what you have in there. How do I get started?
Well, they can definitely go to our website and check out, you know, we've got a pretty detailed website on all the different things we talked about today. It's careerspring.org, www.careerspring.org. There's an I'm interested tab up in the top right-hand corner of the website, and that leads to an interest form. They can say, hey, I'm interested in potentially becoming an employer partner, or I'd like to volunteer as an advisor, and someone will get back to them within a couple of days. Probably same day, but within a couple of days.
Sure.
And, you know, as a reminder, I think as I think about the offering for employers, this is a very tangible, efficient way to give back to your community. So if you're looking for ways like, man, we got to do more for our community, but I don't want everybody to have to leave for the day to go, you know, paint a building over at the school that I used to work at or something like that. This is a way for people to give back. They put in their availability. They can share their wisdom. They don't have to leave their office. They have the call at 3:30, at 4:00, they're back to work. So I think it's that. And then, of course, what we've been talking about today, the pipeline of sure. talent. And over time, I think we're just going to keep getting better and better at that.
I think so, too. And with my experience working with small business owners, this is new. It's different. And they just got to get over themselves and click a button. Really, it's that easy. The to sign up to be an advisor, I think it was like a 5 or 10 minute process. I mean, you guys are in the business of collecting data too, so you can track what's going on. So remember that. It's not just, hey, why can't I just post my job? You guys want to know who it is. You want to be able to track it. You need that data so you can grow the business. So be prepared to spend 15 minutes of time to have access to all these great kids. And as a small business owner, the battle cry, you said it, the battle cry is, we can't find people that want to work. Here's a whole pipeline of kids and young professionals that have worked and are working and want to work. So get over yourself, take the leap, give it a try, right? The worst thing that can happen is you get someone who doesn't work out just like you would if you went through the normal process, right? The worst result is exactly the same as the worst result you get today. The best result is the upside. I think the upside far, like, this is a no-brainer.
Thank you. Thanks, Corey. Yeah, we and you've got us to partner with, right? So we're going to do a lot of the heavy lifting along the way and make it as easy as possible for the small business owners. So I'm grateful, Corey. This has been great. And I appreciate the, you could be our vice president of marketing.
Let's do it. So the other thing before you leave, I will reiterate this because I know you don't want to. You're a not-for-profit. So another way small businesses can help, if you're going to try it, if you hire someone through it, donate. Right. If you're using a recruiting agency, a placement agency, and you brought someone in at $60,000, you're going to pay minimum $10,000 to $20,000 for that. you don't have to give all that, but throw some money Career Springs way so they can keep helping people and helping small business. I think this is an incredible resource for small business owners to get away from that big agency grind and all that stuff. This is just a whole new way to do it. I think it's the young professionals that are coming through this, the upside is greater. There's a huge feel-good factor. Everyone wins when it works. That the kids win, the business wins, Career Spring wins. I love the platform. I was so excited that you agreed to come on here and talk about it. I know you are traveling today, and I appreciate you squeezing us in. You're probably thinking, Corey, I got to get to the airport. But I appreciate you squeezing us in today, man. It has been an absolute pleasure learning even more about Career Spring, and I'm looking forward to doing even more work with you guys.
Thanks so much. I'm truly grateful. Appreciate the time.
Awesome. Thanks, Paul. I appreciate you. Take care. There it is. Paul Pasoli. I got it right. Career Spring. Check them out. It's I've had the opportunity to speak to one of these candidates that they're producing. And as I mentioned earlier, this kid was prepared. He was ready to go. He was out to prove to me he was a young professional ready to take charge. And I believe this young man has a bright, bright future. And if he is a representative of the kids coming through this program, it's incredible. So as a small business owner, if you're looking for young, upstart, hardworking candidates, check out Career Spring. It's such a good organization, and Paul's such a good guy. So check us out. There's lots of ways to check out Key Hire in the podcast, the Small Business Podcast. You can listen to us on Apple, Amazon, Google, Audible, Spotify. We're on all the major platforms. You can watch this on YouTube. Our YouTube channel is pathetic. We need followers. Please click the like, share, follow button on any of these. The podcast, the YouTube station, you can check us out on LinkedIn, the Key Hire Solutions LinkedIn page. Follow us there for any of our updates. We post all of our live streams and podcasts and articles and any news we have going on LinkedIn. Matt, did I miss anything? Free consultation. If you're struggling with talent, if you're looking at creating a new role within your business, or you need to upgrade a role, you have a leader that isn't performing, you're growing and don't have the capital, the human capital, the talent inside the business, you can sign up to meet with us. It's free. It's no weirdness, no sales, just conversation. We're happy to help. If you like what we have to say, we can talk about going further, but you might get everything you need from our conversation and you won't need us. And that would be great too. So until we'll see you in 2 weeks. Don't know what our topic's going to be yet. It'll be a surprise, but we'll see you in 2 weeks. Thanks for tuning in. Until next time, stop grinding and start growing.